full screen tayo and earphones on.
So, yun yung pinaka-essence class. Uunahin mo muna yung outside creditors. Then, susunod, yung priorities na nakalista dito kanina sa ating number 2. Okay, outside creditors. Tatandaan mo kasi ito yung mahalaga. Kahit pa mag-solve na tayo, kung hindi mo naman alam yung proseso, kaya huwag kang masyadong sabik na mag-solve. Dapat alam mo muna yung konsepto because these short rules will govern your computations later on. Ayan. This is one of the common mistakes that students make. They want to jump into solving problems already without knowing the concepts first. Yung gusto ng iba, naaral nila yung concept through solving problems, that is very inefficient. Mas maganda, alam mo muna yung mga rules, even the short rules, the basic concepts, the principles, even before trying to solve problems. Mas smoother yung flow ng problem solving mo later. Okay, so sabi natin, outside creditors, inside creditors, and those owing to capital, last yung sa profit. Okay? Then yung ating order of priority once again. So going back, okay? If the proceeds from sale of the partnership assets are insufficient to pay the creditors, the partners shall contribute the deficiency based on their P&L. So pagka nagkulang, self-explanatory naman, dapat mag-contribute uli yung mga partners based sa kanilang P&L. Ang problema, paano kung merong insolvent? We'll take that up later, okay? Right of offset. There are 3 accounts usually affected by the right of offset. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng right of offset? Okay. Meron kang capital deficiency dito, pero meron ka namang pautang sa partnership dito. Pwede mo siyang i-offset. Ayan. Offset as you know it is the same offset as the term that's being used here. Number 1, due from partner. This account represents a receivable by the partnership from a partner. Okay? Malinaw. Loud and clear. Number 2, partner's loan. This account represents a liability of the partnership to a partner. Malinaw. Okay, utang naman ng partnership sa partner. Kanina, utang ng partner sa partnership. Therefore, receivable ng partnership. Number 3, partner's capital. This account represents the equity of a partner in the partnership. Hindi ko na kailangan ipaliwanag yan. Matagal na nating alam yan. When the partnership is a receivable from a partner, receivable from a partner, and his capital account has a credit balance, the receivable can be offset against the partner's capital account. On the other hand, if the partner has a capital deficiency, debit balance naman, of a partner's capital account, he has a loan account, and he has a loan account, his capital deficiency is offset against his loan account. Tulad ng sabi natin kanina, may capital deficiency ka, pero naman may pautang ka dun sa partnership, pwedeng i-offset yon to cure the negative balance or the debit balance in the capital account. And any excess shall remain to be a loan, o kung kulang man, kakainin niya yung buong loan, mag-additional investment pa yung partner na yon in the event na hindi siya insolvent. Ayan. A receivable account in excess of the partner's capital balance shall be collected from the partner if he is solvent. Tulad na sabi natin, if he is solvent. Even before mabasa natin yung text, nasasabi na natin yung una, eh syempre tayo gumawa nito. Parang nare-recall natin yung sequencing on how we delivered these statements in the book. Otherwise, it is treated as a loss and shared by the remaining partners in the ratio and in their profit and loss ratio. So, tulad ng sabi natin kanina, mag-additional contribution siya pagka siya ay solvent. Pagka naman insolvent, yung negative balance niya sa capital, paghahatian ng mga natitirang partners that are solvent in their profit and loss ratio. Okay? Later on, ma-apply din natin ito dun sa ating problem solving. Next paragraph. A capital deficiency in excess of the loan account shall be collected from the deficient partner if the deficient partner is solvent. Otherwise, treated as a loss to be divided among the remaining partners. Same lang siya dun sa sinabi natin dito. A partner is considered solvent if he has the ability to pay all his liabilities. This means that his assets still exceed his liability. So class, this is a very basic definition of solvency. So for as long as your assets exceed your liabilities, then you are still solvent. Pagka naman hindi na, insolvent ka na. But when you reach your managerial accounting, then you will learn that there is such thing as technical insolvency. that even though your asset exceeds your liabilities, you'll still be insolvent because most of your assets are tied to investments that are not liquid or are not easily convertible into cash. Hopefully, makapag-discuss din tayo ng manageable accounting. Okay. Pagdating mo sa manageable accounting, I suggest panoorin mo yung playlist naman natin for management advisory services. You can find it in our playlist. However, that is review approach naman. Alright. So, di ba, darating ka din dyan. Okay? Lump sum liquidation illustrated. The partnership of A, B, C, and D have been operating for years. Its operations for the past recent years were unfavorable and as a result, the partners decided to liquidate the partnership. Just before liquidation, the statement of financial position appears as follows. Statement of financial position, December 31, 2020. Assets, you have here cash merchandise inventory, 36,000. Non-current assets, furniture and fixtures equipment, 184,000, totaling 220,000. Liabilities and partners equity, you have here accounts payable, notes payable, B loan, D loan, 108,000. Partners equity, partner A, B, C, D, 30-30-2020, you have here 112,000. Total liabilities and partner's equity balance, of course, 220,000. Better nga sana talaga kung meron ka nung libro para habang iniisa-isa natin page per page, may nakakasabay ka habang nagpapahinga ka dyan o nakaupo ka dyan, nakikinig ka dito sa ating lecture. Based on the foregoing information and using the lump sum method of liquidation, the following cases will be illustrated. So sabi natin kanina, there are two ways on how you can liquidate, either the lump sum or the installment liquidation. So una nating illustrate yung minsanan, lump sum. Case number one. Loss on realization fully absorbed by the partner's capital balances. Walang problema sa case number one. Yung loss sa pagbenta ng mga assets, kayang i-absorb ng capital balances. So alam mo na mangyayari, banda dito sa hulian, itong mga cases na to, kukumplika ng kukumplika yung mga yan. Case two. Loss on realization of acquiring offset transfer from partner's loan to capital. Basahin lang natin ang basahin kasi later on, dun mismo sa solution nakasulat din uli ito mga to. Case 3, loss on realization resulting to capital deficiency of one partner who is personally solvent. 4, loss on realization resulting in capital deficiency of one partner personally insolvent naman. 5, loss on realization resulting in capital deficiency of more than one partner pero lahat naman sila ay may kakayanang mag-additional investment solvent. Case 6, loss on realization resulting in capital deficiency uli, more than one partner, deficient partners are personally insolvent. Tulad ng nasabi na natin kanina, i-absorb ng ibang partners yung negative balance sa capital ng insolvent. Kasi wala na siyang kakayanang mag-additional investment. Case 7, cash insufficient to pay creditors. Ito, malala. So, wala nang cash pambayad sa creditors. Pero lahat naman sila personally solvent. So, kaya mag-additional investment, magdadagdag. Case 8, cash insufficient to pay creditors. Some deficient partners ay insolvent pa. Paano na kaya yan? Anyway, later on, pag nilagyan na natin ng peso figures itong illustrations natin na to, mas maiintindihan mo siya. Alright? Statement of realization and liquidation. A statement of realization and liquidation summarizes all liquidation activities, reflecting how assets are realized, how losses are shared among the partners, how expenses are paid, and how liabilities are satisfied, and the eventual payments to partners in case of residual cash. Case number one, loss on realization fully absorbed by partners' capital balances. So, babalikan natin lahat ng mga balances just before the liquidation starts. Assume that all non-cash assets of the partnership were sold for 156,000. So, makikita natin yung mga balances natin dito, just like for cash, 24,000. That is the balance in the given ABCD Partnership Statement of Financial Position, December 31, 2020. For the non-cash assets, this is the accumulated amount of all assets except for the cash, namely your merchandise inventory, you have your furniture and fixtures net, and your equipment. Ito yung total ng 12,000, 100,000, and 84,000. So you please go check them out kasi dun talaga tayo magsisimula sa mga balances na yon. For the liabilities of 93,000 naman, kailangan ihiwalay yung mga utang ng partnership doon sa partners. Kasi pag sinabing liability dito sa liquidation format natin, it must be outside creditors only. Kasi iba yung consideration ng inside creditors. Ayan. So B loan and D loan of 8,000 and 7,000. So lumalabas yung 93,000, that is the 60,000 accounts payable and the 33,000 notes payable. So 93 yun. A capital 44, B capital 33,500, C capital 22,500, D capital, that is your 12,000. According to the first case, non-cash assets will be sold for 156,000. So if the non-current assets has a total book value of 196, e nabenta lang siya for 156,000, ibig sabihin, there must have been a loss of how much? 40,000, which would have been divided. Dapat paghati-hatian ng partners yung loss na yon with their profit and loss ratio. Okay? So, 12,000 goes to A, 12,000 goes to B, parehas silang 30%. 22,500 less 8,000 naman yung share ni C dun sa loss na yon, and 8,000 for D. So, kaya pa siguro nating i-increase yung... Ayan, i-zoom in muna natin ng konti for the meantime. Ayan. The journal entries to record the liquidation are as follows. So, tuloy muna natin yung computation dito sa taas. After dividing the loss on the disposal, eto na yung ating mga balances. You have 180, wala na tayong non-current assets, liabilities 93, B loan, D loan, A capital, B capital, C capital, and D capital. Next one would be to pay yung ating first priority, which would be the external creditors. So we have sufficient cash, 180,000. Ang external creditors natin, we owe them 93,000, so babayaran natin. Mababawasan yung cash, mawawala na din yung liabilities. So zero na tayo dito, double rule. 87,000 for the balances. And this one would be the balances carried over from the above balances. So wala na tayong ibang gagawin dito, kundi ipamigay yung cash dun sa partners. But take note, meron pa tayong internal creditors, yung utang ng partnership dun sa partners. So compared to the capital balances, mas merong priority pa rin yung loan ni B, yung loan ni D, pautang ni B at saka ni D sa partnership. So babayaran natin yun. And the remaining would be given to the partners. So, hindi masyadong komplikado itong ating case number one. So, as we have told you, the cases are in increasing breadth of difficulty. Hanggang later on, pagka insolvent na yung iba, hindi makakontribute ng additional cash, and then papano kung may utang pa sa external creditor. So, we'll show them later. The journal entries to record the liquidation are as follows. So, unang nangyari, eto. Dinispose yung non-cash assets. So, debit cash for the amount received, credit the assets that were sold, and the loss for 40,000. Yan yung pinaghati-hatian ng mga partners. So, please take note dito sa ating binago ng konti kasi may simple typographical error dyan. Simple case of copy and paste, hindi na napalitan. Ito yung correct journal entry. Okay? Credit the loss and debit the capital accounts. Kasi ito, okay, naka-debit siya, so pag credit mo siya dito, mawawala na, malulusaw. And then, paghahati-hatian naman ng mga partners, bawas yan dun sa kanilang capital accounts. Yan din yung figures class na pinakita natin dito sa ating computation dito sa taas. So, 12,000, 12,000, 8,000, and 8,000. These are those figures. The next that we have done there was to pay the creditors. So sabi natin yung 93, yan yung aggregate amount ng accounts payable tsaka yung notes payable. So 60,000, 33,000. Okay? Payment of loans. You have here B loan, D loan, cash. Nauna yon. As we have said, those have priority over the capital accounts. Yung kanilang mga capital, bago mabayaran, bayaran muna lahat ng utang. So una, external and then internal creditors. And then finally, yung natitirang pera, 72,000, will be distributed according to this amount as computed in the above solution. After giving effect to the losses absorbed by the partners in the second journal entry, the capital balances are equal to the amounts debited here. Ayan. So we are done with the case number one. Case number two, loss on realization requiring offset or transfer from partner's loan to the capital account. Ano ba yung tinatawag nating right of offset as we have discussed already? Okay. So later, papakita natin. Assume that all the non-cash assets were sold for 126,000. Magkano na nga ba natin nabenta kanina sa case number 1? 156. So expected, lilit ng lilit yung mapagbentaan dito sa assumptions natin. Hanggang magipit na yung partners, titignan natin kung ano mangyayari. Once again, the beginning balances here are all taken from the statement of financial position just before the liquidation starts. Okay? Hanggang dito sa ating 12,000. Disposal of non-cash assets, this time 126. So following the same procedure, walang bago dito. Basta yung loss, which is 70,000, difference between 196 and 126. E loss yun klase. Eh. So anong mag-govern doon? Siyempre, yung profit and loss ratio. So, paghahati-hatian nila yun. I-re-resolve muna natin yon, and then we go to the first priority of, paano? Paying the outside creditors. Pero pagkatapos ng bentahan, makikita natin dito that this share in the loss, in case number 2, is more than what his capital balance could bear. Kasi 12,000 na lang yung balance na dito, 14,000 yung loss niya. Dun sa 70, share niya sa loss, okay? 14,000 yung share niya sa loss out of the total loss na 70,000. So 12,000. Anong gagawin natin? Before proceeding to the payment of the external creditors, kailangan i-resolve mo muna yung negative balance dun sa capital account. E nag-negative nga siya dito, class. Let's change color for a while. For distinction, nag-negative nga siya dito, class. However, SCD, makikita mo may pautang pala sa partnership na 7,000. Yan yung binabanggit natin na right of offset. Eh? Nag-negative ako, pero meron naman akong pautang sa samahan natin, sa partnership natin. So what should I do? O pwedeng ibawas na lang natin, i-offset na lang natin dun sa pautang ko sa partnership. So yun yung tinatawag na right of offset. Kaya sabi natin dito, offset of the loan. That is why the 7,000 became 5,000 at nawala yung negative balance niya dito, alright, binawas doon, kaya zero balance na yung kanyang capital account. Then the next procedure would be to bring down the balances, so 150, wala na yan, nag-zero na doon, so double rule. 93 dito, 8,023 from above, 12,500 and then 8,500.